weeks out of your life, where will you be? It'll be too late. That last breath is gone. When that bell rings out, it's gone. When that bell rings, you're finished. Where are you going to be? Where are you going to be that day if you don't know Jesus and you're going to save him? Where are you going to be? You need to take stock. You need to come to that reality of God's saving grace. Where will you be that day if you stand before him? It's alright to walk on by today and a nice sunny day has brought you out. What happens when the rain comes? What happens when you find out that it's not going to always be this thing? You have an eternal destiny. Where are you going to be in that life? Where are you going to spend that eternity? Whether you believe it or not, you've got an eternal destiny. You need to get in the right place. You need to get in the right place and make the right choice. The choice counts. We've got an eternal destiny. God has done it as a wife of making the wrong choice. That's what the cross is all about. Whatever he thinks of that sacrifice that he gave to us, he didn't die for himself, he died for us. So that we can have an eternal destiny. That we need to be separate anymore. Because that's what our sin does, it separates us from God. But the blood of Jesus breaks it down through the forgiveness he offers. We've only got to invite him in. We've only got to acknowledge that sacrifice and invite him in. And that sin barrier can be broken down. That sin barrier can be took out of the way. And we can have fellowship with him. We can know that the love and the power of God is real and it works. And what will be long for that day when you stand before him and you're face to face with the truth? The truth that only Jesus saves. When we stand before that great throne, where will you be in that day? Trembling, frightened, because we know we were told about him. We know that he came and died for us. But when we stand before him, what will our hope be? What will our chances be when we reject him? You see, hell is a real place, just like heaven. Hell is a real place for those who want to spend their eternity screaming and crying out that Jesus came, that no one should go there. No one should go there. That you shouldn't scream or cry out. But let the love of God be a reality for you. Let the love of God be a reality to you. Jesus said you must be born again. That's the only Christian there is. Do you know that? Jesus said you must be born again. You will not enter the kingdom of heaven unless you are born again. You must be born again. Not born of the flesh, but born of the spirit and life. Get the fullness of life in you that Jesus came to bring. He said, I come to give it to you. Why haven't you got it? Why don't you know that life? How many years you've been on the planet and you still don't know that life? It's about time we had something different. Something more than the struggle of life that you've got now.